Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Old School with you here. And getting into some Fallout 4 build, a lot of times you get to a settlement and there's certain things that are in the settlement already that I'd like to keep, but I just don't like where they're at, but you can't move them. You can only scrap them. And most of the time it's cars that I'm interested in keeping. Accidentally found out that with some collision techniques, you can actually move the cars. Now, it's not easy and it takes a lot of practice. Right now we're looking at when I first discovered what could be done. And I was using a rug glitch along with any piece of furniture, but I happen to use the shelves, the two-tier shelves, and I'm able to move this car all over the place. Now, what you want to do once you get it anywhere near where you want it is to make sure you do a quick save because it may just go out of bounds. And at this point in time, I can't possibly move it back in, so I had to load into my previous save, put the car back where it was, and then try moving it again. I'm starting to get the hang of it at this point. What you want to do is make very small incremental moves and a lot more of it. Pushing from the front back didn't seem to work so well, but from the sides, I could pretty much twirl it around and push it into the area I want. And what I want to do with this particular car is park it next to the existing house that I've already repatched and got all set and ready to go. And hopefully, at the end of the day, this is all going to come together. This is Country Crossing, by the way. And that's where you'll find the same vehicle, unless you've already scrapped it. But if you haven't, it's still there. And this is the only one I can recall at any of the settlements that was complete. Tires and all. Beat to hell, but it's got the wheels, it's got the doors, it's got a roof, it's all intact. Again, a lot of these little nudges just to put it into position. And one of the things I did come across as it went on, once I got the car to a certain point in the landscape and it was a downhill slope, then pushing it from the front had a little bit more of an effect. It would go down with gravity. As soon as everything is put into place, I'm going to give you a quick tour of my final build for County Crossing, at least for now. I have a lot of potential for doing more with it. And this was a complete reimagination because my original Country Crossing was done early on in my gameplay and my building styles have changed quite a bit. And I've learned a lot more about building techniques. So I basically came in, scrapped almost everything I had and started from scratch. And this is where I learned about this little glitch. Again, moving the item of furniture around on the carpet definitely makes a difference because you can attack the object from different aspects. So right here, I'm going to take the hasset and I'm going to move it more to the corner where it's almost free floating. And that allows it to go a little deeper underneath the car. And if you catch it just right, it'll pop up for you. And again, you got to try and negotiate with what it gives you. But it can be done, just takes a little bit of practice, a little time, a lot of patience. It's almost in position right where I want it right now. I just want to get it back so it's not blocking the tool bench. Got a doll, baby. I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's anything but calm. A regular pint size atom bomb. Atom bomb, baby. Atom bomb. Atom bomb baby, loaded with power, radioactive as a TV tower, a nuclear fission in her soul.
washed away. I want it to be a million times higher than TNT.
Thanks for watching video. Drop a like below, and there'll be more Fallout 4 right here on ANG.